And now we will learn how to put labels on variable values. Why use numeric values with labels instead of just using non-numeric values like we have been doing in earlier videos? Well, that's because we can run more analysis and manage the data values more efficiently if instead of using non-numeric variables, we use numeric variables and put on labels. We must be the ones to tell Stata what labels go with what values. For example, we will use the same data set that has a variable called gender. And we will tell Stata the value number 1 will be labeled male and the value number 2 will be labeled female. When it comes to the variable continent, we will label Asia with we will label the value number 1 with the word Asia, the value number 2 with the word Australia, the value of 3 with Europe, the value with 4 North America, and the value with 5 South America. So what does that mean? Well, when you look at the previous data set, gender and continent were non-numeric values, and we could not use replace or recode in order to change them to different values because they were non-numeric. However, if we change all of the appearances of male to the number 1 and all the appearances of female to the number 2, then they're numeric values, and we can do things like recode and replace to change the variables very quickly. Same thing with continent. If we change Asia to the value of 1 and so on, we'll be able to do that. Now look closely at gender, look closely at continent. Now this is what the data sheet would look like if we changed it. Again, previously it would be male, female, female in observation number 1, 2, and 3. But over here, we changed male to number 1 and female to number 2. So now they're numeric values that correspond with the non-numeric values where 1 is male and 2 is female. Same thing with continent. Asia has the value of 1, so that's why the top one is 1. The second one here, North America, we assign the value of 4. So the number 4 will be labeled North America. When we finish putting on the labels, it will go back to looking like the way it looked, but the only difference is we will think we're managing non-numeric characters, but the computer will know that they're numbers with labels. There are two simple steps to giving a value label to a variable. That means there are two simple lines of code. In the first line of code, you create the label, and in that very same first line of code, tell Stata what words go with what numbers. So you're assigning words to the numeric values for that label. Then in the second step, for the second line of code, you simply connect the label that you created in the first step with the variable you would like it to be with. So in our first example, we're going to give label values to the variable gender. And a moment ago I had said the value number 1 will have the label male and the value number 2 will have the label female. So here's the first line of code that I'm about to type in. The words label define tells command Stata to create a new label, and the word that follows is the name of the label. This is not the name of the variable, this is the name of the label. And in step 1, Stata doesn't even know which variable it's going to be connected to. It's just tell Stata you're creating a label, and here's the name of the label you're creating. Then in the third part of the line, tell Stata what numbers get which words. So, for whichever variable we place this label on, when that variable has the number 1, you will see the word male. When that variable has the number 2, you will see the word female. But even though we type in this line of code, Stata does not yet know which variable this will be applied to until the second line of code. So let me go ahead and type in this line. So first the commands, label define, space. Now the name of the label, gender label, okay, and then space, one, space, quote, male. We should actually put it in caps because that's how we had the words before. Male, quote, space, two, space, quote, female, close quote. This is exactly, these are exactly the lines of the syntax for the first line of code that was explained. When I hit enter, I did not get an error message. But the data sheet did not change because all we did was create the label. We have not yet applied the label to the variable. The second line of code is very simple. You type in label values, which tells Stata you're going to apply the label you created to a particular variable. So the command is label values, then type in the name of the variable that you're using and the label that you're putting on. So you type in label values, then gender, because that's the variable that will get the label, then gender label, which is the label that you're putting. So let me go ahead and type that in. Label values, gender, gender label. Label values, space, gender. Oh, excuse me, it should really be lowercase. Label values. Label values. Now, what was the other one? Gender, which is the name of the variable. And the name of the label was gender label. That's the variable we created in the previous step. Hit enter. If we did not get an error message, we can take a look at the data sheet, and lo and behold, all of the number ones show the word male, and all of the number twos in the data set show the word female. Now, watch what happens when I click in a particular value and I type in the number 1, hit enter, it becomes male. I type in the number 2, it shows female. Well, gee, what if I typed in the number 3? Nothing, because we gave no label value for 3. What if we type in the number 4? Nothing, because we gave no values for 4. We have to turn it back to what it was, which I believe was the number 2, female. In order to help you see what values go with what labels, you can run a table with the values or the labels. In fact, sometimes you will need to run both. With large data sets, that may be the only way to know what values are associated with what numbers. So we all remember from the earlier videos, the tab command will give us a table of the variable that we ask for. So we're asking for a table of the variable gender. And just like it looked in earlier videos, there are 10 appearances of male and 10 appearances of female in the variable gender. But the difference this time is, if we type it in again, tab gender, then put a comma space N-O-L. When you put comma space N-O-L after asking for a table, you're telling Stata, give me the same table with no labels. And when we hit enter, you see the number 1, which represents male, still has 10, and the number 2, that represents female, also has 10. So sometimes you have to run a table with the labels to see what they are, then run them again without the labels to understand that the number 1 is what the value of male is, and number 2 is what the assigned value of female is. And sometimes running tables this way is the only way to find out, especially if a data sheet is really big with lots and lots of numbers and lots of data. In order to fully understand this, we're going to give you a second example. Here are the values in the variable continent that are in the data sheet now, and here are the labels that we're going to assign to those values. And after this second example, you will clearly understand the idea of values and labels. Okay, so the first line of code should be exactly this. The command label define, then the name of the label. Stata doesn't know what variable it's going to go on yet. All it knows is it's going to be called C-label for continent label. And that any variable that this label gets assigned to, the value of 1 in that variable will read the word Asia. The value of 2 in that variable will read the word Australia, and so on. So now you can pause this video at this moment and type this into the command line. Label define is telling Stata to create a label. C-label follows label define, so Stata knows that's the name of the label. Now, whichever variable you assign this label to, when that variable has the value of 1, you will see the word Asia. When that variable has the value of 2, you will see the word Australia, and so on. So I bring the cursor to the end of the line, and I hit enter, and as you can see, we've created the label with no error message. And now the second line of code assigns the label to the variable. Label values, which means we're going to take a previously created label and put it on an existing variable. So you type label values, the name of the variable, and the name of the label. So let's do that. Label values, the name of the variable in this case is continent, and the name of the label was C-label. Now when we hit enter, we get no error message, but now when we look at the data sheet, aha! Where you used to see the number 1, you see Asia. Where you previously saw the number 4, you see North America. Where you previously saw the number 5, you see South America. Now watch this. When I click here and change this to the number 2 and hit enter, it says Australia. If I change it to the number 3 and hit enter, it says Europe. If I change it to the number 4 and hit enter, it says North America. If I put 5, it says South America. But if I put the number 6, it just leaves the number 6. Because when we created the variable, we did not tell Stata what label the value of 6 should have. So that's the reason why. Let's change it back to 1. I believe it was 1. Let's change it back. And that shows that the numbers are there, but they are behind the labels. So now let's run a table to see how it looks. Tab, then the name of the variable, continent, then hit enter. And now, instead of seeing numbers, you see the frequency of appearances of each continent, and that's the way it looked in prior videos when they were non-numeric values. But now, they're numeric values with labels. So when I type, I can put comma N-O-L and hit enter. And if I look at both tables at the same time, what I can see is that Asia has the numeric value of 1. Australia has the numeric value of 2, and so on. So by running a table with the labels and running a table without the labels, I can see what numeric values are associated with which words regarding that particular variable. So now that the variables are numeric with labels, we can use the Recode command to change all of the appearances of Asia to the word Australia. We simply type in Recode, the name of the variable, and all of the number one values of that variable will become number two. That means that every time you saw the word Asia, you will now see the word Australia. And you can see how handy this would be if we had 5,000 rows and 60 columns and we were not able to change them ourselves if they were non-numeric. So I'm going to type in exactly these words. Recode continent, recode the variable. In this variable continent, everything that was the number one becomes the number two. Now, before we do that, let's look at the tables. Okay? Number one is Asia, and number two is Australia. That means after we recode, instead of having six instances of the word Asia and four instances of the word Australia, we'll have 10 instances of the word Australia and none of Asia, because all of the number ones, which is Asia, have become number two, which is Australia. So we hit enter. Now I'm going to type tab continent, hit enter, and now you can see there are 10 instances of the word Australia and no appearances of the word Asia, because all of the values of one have become number two, which means there are no number ones anymore, which means Asia is not in the table. Number two is Australia, and now there are 10 instances of that.